Hey, welcome to episode 70 of The 6-Inch Show, a show that looks and loves Hasbro generally, Star Wars, the Black Series, Marvel Legends, G.I. Joe Classified, and a whole bunch of other stuff too. My name is Fly Guy from FlyGuy.net, joined as always this way by Mr. Matt from Instagram.com/Star Wars The Black Series and many more. Mr. Instagram, how the hell are you?
Yeah, doing good.
Nice. Like a shelf going on there, very good. We've not looked at that in a while. Yep. Mountain Trooper, Hondo, Kingpin, and Boba?
Well, it's the kind of Boba Fett, but it's the Gonk Toys acrylic case that I've got it in. I got one of those in-between shows, and Boba Fett went in there. Kenneth Fett went in there.
We'll have to give them a plug, the manufacturer. Cool. I do like my cases and displays. So it has been 3 or 4 weeks, I think, since the last show. Today, yesterday, kind of in the last few hours anyway, kind of was Mando Monday. So we're going to bring you some fresh, up-to-date news. There's only one or two releases for 6-inch, but some other good stuff if you're into vintage collection or other stuff. But as usual, let's kick off and look back at the last show, episode 69, and your comments to see what you guys were saying. Let's have a little look. 6-inch show, episode 69. So Biker Scout 74 was going on about, and he noticed something I didn't notice, which was the digital render of the Return of the Jedi Boba Fett. The helmet didn't have the right deco on it, so good on you, Biker Scout, for spotting that one. I did not notice that. UFAFEK is talking about the armorer's hair is kind of looking like her hair instead of fur. Interesting. People are into Jar Jar and Dark Ray. The Forces with Jesse is... I won't repeat that. You can read that on screen. He's excited, shall we say, for Dark Ray, kinky boy. What's going on here? They were talking about the Razor Crest, Credit Mando reveals. I don't like carbonized figures. I've seen a lot of people say that. Something for everyone. Hasbro's definitely trying to cater in every way. Retro figures, the vintage collection figures, Black Series figures, then make you rebuy them all again as the carbonized figures, and then the credit collection figures. So, yeah, there's a lot of this stuff. I like another comment by Forces with Jesse here. I was initially tempted by the Christmas shit because it's so ridiculously stupid that I had to have them. Then Zing put up the pre-order for 55 each, so I'm going to go ahead and save myself $275. I totally agree with you, Jesse, the Christmas
show. I'm not sure if he backed out of that. I think he might have got
some.
Maybe
you reviewed one or something. Did you
cave? I'm going to have a look. I'm going to have a look to see if he caved while you keep going.
I think he did, actually. I think I remember seeing a review or something because he bought a big haul or something. I'm so behind on watching videos. I'm terrible. But in saying that, a lot of people did not like those figures, and a lot of people did. So kudos to Hasbro for trying it. Although there is at least 12 of each figure at my local store, and they're not going anywhere.
I don't think he did. I'm going to have to give him credit. He didn't. He hasn't buckled. Good on you, Jesse.
$55 for a single figure. Anyway, that's Australian dollars for those watching. Judge Jace is saying this Christmas Black Series look like China bootlegs. Oh, dear. However, the colours on the four credit collection figures really make them pop. And was both pleased and pained in equal measure to pre-order them. I agree, man. I were just talking about this before the show. It's kind of like, it's a lot of money to buy the same figure again for a bit of cardboard and a splash of paint. It's getting a bit rich, man. But then again, we don't need to buy them. And I still bought them. So there you go. The odd thing about the Cobra Viper, says Adkins Lawn Care, cool name, by the way, is that in the US, they were already on shelves before Hasbro revealed. Well, there you go. That's very true. A lot of stores had put their stock out just a little bit early. So Linda Borham, hello, great to females on the show and watching. Hasbro, I work hard for my money, just like the song. God bless you, Donna Summer. But I'm tired of working even harder to try and give it to you. I really want to give you my money. Why is a collector of lines I get the feeling that you actually do not want my money? It seems you'd rather go into scalpers or perhaps a different company altogether. Ooh, a little bit controversially, I think Matt and I will be touching on that later on with some of the other reveals. The availability is pretty hard. And that's even for people in the States with Targets, with Walmarts, and they can't find them. But there you go. Kenneth Crayley's back, has all, nearly all 70 shows. Good on you, Kenneth Crayley. Jason Staber is saying that it occurs to me that in 2021, besides being Lucasfilm's 50th anniversary, it's also the 40th anniversary of Raiders of the Lost Ark. We were talking about that last week. I would be so chuffed if they brought a 6-inch line. They got to do it. They got to do it. Mick Scarab Trooper was saying, I live in America and I like doing Christmas photos on my Instagram, but those Christmas figures look like a cheap cash grab, in my opinion. Okay, so most people are not liking them here in the comments. Jason Cohen is saying the blue old body clone lieutenant is the arm on the left of the phase one clone.
No, that's of the art packets. We were talking about. Gotcha. Something else is coming, but it's actually the exclusive, Walgreens exclusive.
Nice. Christopher Miller gave us a timed response with individual segments. Good on you, Chris. He's corrected us on a few points. Thank you for that. Always deliver a good correction, which is good.
That was the Echo one that had come out just hours before we'd done the show, and it was ended up being a Plasma Pulse series, whatever the collection's called, but it's not 6-inch scale, which was just, I don't know. So wasted effort.
The Ghostbusters Ecto one is not, doesn't fit.
6-inch. It's not. It's 1/18 or something. It's smaller, but it belongs to the 6-inch line, and it's just, it's hold on, crazy. Hold on.
It doesn't fit the figures.
No.
Are you kidding me?
Nope. It doesn't fit the figures. That's why it was £50 or whatever it was. It was so cheap.
We're not talking about the same one, are we, man?
Yeah, we are.
Oh, crap. Hold on a minute. Sorry, people. We'll get back to comics in just a second. Some serious stuff has happened here. What is going on? They did. You know what? No wonder they didn't put a figure inside the vehicle. Of course they sold out. Good God. Xavi had it. Come on. Well, that's getting cancelled. If that doesn't fit these figures, I ain't buying an Ecto one if it's not going to put the damn figures inside it.
It definitely doesn't.
Oh my God, that sucks. Okay, this is just not happening here. Come on, what's going on? Come on, Google. Find me. We get toys to check out and orders to cancel. Come on, internet. Ghostbusters Ecto 1. Let's have a look. Yeah, because they had it. Back to a 6-inch scale.
Where?
And it,
everyone I know has been saying it's 1/118. Have a look again. Click on it, see what they say inside it.
Okay. Oh, okay. Do you know, it does not show that the figures are in it, which is a good point. I mean, why would they do that? That's insane.
Yep. Everything's there. Like, I mean...
So it's in scale, but they don't fit in it. What? Surely not. I mean, it's part of the goddamn line.
Yeah. That's why it didn't make sense to me. But it's like £50. That's really cheap for something that's meant to be a... It'd have to be like that big to be a 6-inch Ecto.
That does make sense, but that also absolutely sucks ass. That's appalling. Why would you do that? I mean, oh, God. Yeah. Makes sense now because there's no figures inside it. I mean, they would have shown the Ghostbusters Plasma series figures and vehicles from the Ghostbusters each sold separately. Okay, we'll get into this later on, but God damn it, Hasbro. Anyway, back on. Roberto Blues was saying the Christmas figures are not AliExpressive, Well, he's commented that my comment about AliExpress exclusives. So there you go. Jesse, you've been popular this comment section. Very good. Christopher Miller again likes the colours of the credit collection. I do too. I think they're really good. I think they do look really nice. Scott FF is asking us, how did you score that Mr. T? Did you have a Mr. T? Because I don't have a Mr. T.
Yeah, I got one from Bulletproof Villain in Australia.
Bobatan, Marvel Legends, Retro Target exclusives, is Thomas Dodson. Nathan Dean's view was the only one of the holiday specials that was good was the Range Trooper. I kind of have to agree, actually. I think that did look more Santa-like and Christmassy than others. And sadly, the Ecto-1 is not 6-inch scale, but 1/18 scale. That's getting cancelled. Thanks, dude. dudes, you should mention as well. Christopher Miller again is happy GG is out. Why does Jar Jar have a spear? Did he use one in The Phantom Menace?
I don't think so. I think he used the thing that he hit his face with. The slingshot?
But I don't think he had a spear. True. Yet again, more on the Christmas stuff from David Kosh. I'm disappointing the holiday figures. They spent useless time on them. Darkseid Rays next straight out. It is a digital render, so hang in there on that one. The Incinerator's fuel tank is upside down. Is it? The Phase 1 Clone Trooper's helmet is not movie accurate. And honestly, it's not hard to make Cody's helmet removable. I'm still going to buy some of these figures, but it's disappointing. I think he's got a very valid point there. There's a lot of... because collectors were going to niggle. We do. This is the point of this show. This is the point of you guys commenting on this show too. I think it's just we try and be constructive. We've got to remember that at the end of the day, we are getting toys and figures of some of this stuff. And without Hasbro doing it, we don't quite know if some of these would get made. But it is getting tired when, you know, we're just talking earlier on. There's the Mandalorian came out in the 6-inch line. Then he came out carbonized. Then they came out something else, didn't he? He came out
with Beskar. He's come out with Beskar.
Beskar, which was the jetpack. And now, so that's the credit collection. And now, which we're about to reveal the Mando Monday, that's the fifth version of the same figure in 1 year, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
That's taking the piss, I think. I think that goes above the barrier of slightly taking the piss on the same figure. But then again, they're all slightly different, slightly.
Five. They're slightly different, but is it five? I'm sorry, we did the first one.
First one, carbonized.
Carbonized, yes, okay. Then we did credits, then we did Beskar, and now we're doing removable helmet with all the added extras.
And you know it won't be the last.
No. Well, you know that there's going to be still something slightly different about him in season two.
Right. So,
and we're going to get the season two one where maybe he gets the other shin pad. Who knows?
Season eight, it'll be just finally complete. You'll have it fully Beskar'd. Anyway, thank you to everybody who watched episode 69 and all your comments. Were very interesting and fun, and thank you for that. News straight up then of what has happened in the last period of Star Wars. Mando Monday happened literally just fresh off the block. In terms of what was shared, let me just share this here. Only a couple of 6-inch figures, one which we just mentioned there, which was this other fifth release of The Mandalorian. The Black Series, and now they're not calling them The Mandalorian, they're calling them Din Djarin, if that's the correct pronunciation. But it's basically a helmet off Mando, which we'll show you in just a minute. We'll go into some photographs and show you much more detail. And also a repaint of a biker scout with a baby Yoda in, or the child, inside a satchel. Again, we'll show you that in just a sec. That is a Target exclusive, $50 for that, and $35.
Target exclusive for Mando and an Amazon exclusive for the
Scout. It's the way this image is kind of laid out. You're absolutely right. Yes, Amazon for the Biker Scout and Target for the Mando. Yes.
Although I did just notice saying that when you opened up Zavi, Mando was on Zavi as well.
Well, there you go. And he's also turned up at Zing pop culture in Australia.
In Australia, and yeah, but he was, when you just entered in Zavi before.
Yep.
He was there in the left-hand corner.
Well, there you go. And no doubt, if you're in the UK, Star Action Figures, Dakota UK, we'll just check that we have kind of slightly globalized everybody. We've, it would help if I could spell Star Action Figures. I did spell Star Action Figures.
Are you having trouble getting on the site?
Yeah.
Probably because the Mando Monday's gone on sale and it's congested.
It is. We're experiencing unusually high levels of traffic. Oh, well, there you go. So check that out for them. But let's get a look at the photo.
So one will assume they've got it.
One will assume they've got it, indeed. Go now, as of time of recording. Let's get a look at some of these figures, and I'll just share a screen of the press images that Hasbro kindly sent. So, Din Djarin, if that's counted,
It's just Din Djarin.
Din Djarin.
It's like Django Unchained.
Okay, there you go. So, beautiful artwork yet again, loving it. It's going to be a huge box, so it's going to be jutting out of your collection, but if you move things around, it would look very nice. I wonder if there's artwork at the side there, because...
Have you opened it up yet? Because I'm just seeing just the page.
Let me just... I wonder if that's just sharing properly. Let me just reshare here. There we go. That should probably do it. Better?
There we go.
Cool, cool.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm just saying the artwork on the side of it looks like there's another figure's leg or robe or something.
Yeah, so I saw someone saying that it's... they think, and I'm not sure whether it's the blaster or something, someone's been claiming that it's Moff Gideon. I'm not sure what or how that must be his gun.
Yeah, interesting. So even though it's a bigger figure, to try and get that diorama going with all those, it's going to be kind of weird because this is a much bigger package. You can see the width of it there is just huge. So
it's going to be Zeb-like.
Correct. So it won't be too bad. So I had a quick look at this today in just a little bit more detail. Same figure, no difference, apart from the helmet underneath, which they don't show here at all, but we'll get to that in just a minute. So same weapon, same figures, looks to be the same paint entirely. You get 5 pieces of Beskar, 1 tracking fob, 1 little egg crib for Baby Yoda, and it looks to be the same Baby Yoda figure that we've had before. Yes, it is. I don't see any difference to that. So it's basically a couple of bits and pieces and the head, because the cape's still not soft goods, which I think is pretty criminal at this point to not include that. But there we go. That's my thoughts on it. What's your thoughts as you guys watch it? I'm buying the same figure again. It's a great figure. Don't get me wrong.
The helmet, the helmet look, to me, the helmet looks slightly, obviously it's different because it can fit a head in it, but it looks like a better helmet. It looks looks more silver, but that could still be the prototype, but it just looks a little bit more...
Shiny,
but also, again, it looks like a helmet this time because others have complained that the other one's a little bit too round. And this one, I think, is working a little bit more accurately.
I thought this was a swap-out head. I didn't actually see any... This looks a little odd. Looks a little fat in the cheeks.
Yeah, but...
I don't know. It's him.
Look, it's him, and I think people want the good-looking... what's his name? What was his name in Game of Thrones?
Oh, Prince Oberon or something.
Yeah, Prince Oberon. But it's like people have been commenting on my page about how he looks ugly and he looks this and that. And I'm just going to put it out there. When he takes his mask off and he's all beaten and bloody.
Yeah.
True. My wife did say at the time, he's looking like a bit of a bad drunk. And that's what this head looks like. Mm. He was looking puffy. He was looking, he wasn't looking like the Prince of Oberon in episode 7 or 8, whenever he took the mask off episode 8.
Mm. No, he wasn't.
That's pretty, it's pretty accurate. He was looking horrible. But then again, he's been wearing a mask for 25 years.
you can just see a tiny little bit the chin underneath there. So yeah, it is. It's not a swap boot head. It's a a different helmet. Yeah, look, it is a great figure. He looks great on the shelf already. So this edition of, I mean, this kind of should have came out before this, but never mind. We're buying it again. There we go. So all the bits and pieces. I thought it was a drum.
It's the bits and pieces.
Is that on the 3.75 inch? There's a white drum, is there not? Am I thinking
a white what?
A white storage container for the.
Oh, that's the 3.75 inch non-exclusive out of the Razor Crest. And see, that's what's missing from this too. That should just be
exactly. There. Oh my god!
The ice cream machine.
Exactly, the ice cream machine. Thank you. So yeah, I mean it's great and all, but. Anyway, okay, fair enough. Next 6-inch release from Hasbro on Mando Monday is the Speederbike Scout Trooper and the Child. So this is a repaint of the previous Biker Scout. If some of you won't even remember because you're new to collecting, you won't remember. There was a Biker Scout in the past. This is repainted in white. It looks absolutely identical. It's a Biker Scout from before. There doesn't appear to be any differences other than paint. And it's still a great figure, so why should there be? Baby Yoda inside the satchel, which you can close.
Is that, if we just go back to the other image, is it a new Baby Yoda? Does the other Baby Yoda's ears bend up like that one?
This one here you're talking about?
Yeah, see, Baby Yoda's ears are straight there. And then look at Baby Yoda's ears in the bag.
Oh no! I'm saying this one here is a pre. This is a.
Is the same as the other one? Yeah, I'm just saying on the
On the other one, no, I think that's Trooper.
That's a new Baby Yoda.
Yeah, it's a new Baby Yoda. I think that's a one piece. I doubt it will be articulated. We don't get to see either way, but I think that'll just be a slot in Baby Yoda.
a one piece
bag of Yoda. Exactly. We get this included in here, which. I know what that is. That's the brake pads. It's the brake pads that go on. Well, maybe it's not.
I don't know what it is.
I think it's the other side's brake pad on the box. I'll show you what I mean in a minute. Let me just skim ahead. Yeah, I think it is. Anyway, it's this part here, I believe. If not, I don't know what the feck it is. What is that? If you're watching, let us know. Leave a note in the comments. I must say, I love the artwork. That is just awesome. Love that artwork there. And little Baby Yoda. Do you know, I'm waiting for the day when they re-release that crap IG-11 on the speeder bike with the same Baby Yoda.
They would have to make a new IG-11 because his legs don't bend, do they? I can't remember.
No, they don't. They don't. That's the perfect excuse for them to do that, actually. Oh, what am I saying? You know they're making it. You know they're making it. So, there doesn't seem to be any placement of that other part. So, I don't know what that is. Maybe there was something in the show, like a...
I can't remember. Is it something from when they're camping? Or is it what they're shooting or throwing things at? I don't know.
I think that head is just stuck inside the bag.
Stuck into the plastic, yeah.
Yeah, I don't think it's actually going to pop out. The head looks.
I wonder if we could pop it out of the bag and put it on the other body.
Yeah, it doesn't appear. It appears to be this part. I think. I don't know. That wouldn't make sense because that's all one piece. Anyway, if you're watching, let us know. So Biker Scout with dirt, effectively, is what's been added. I don't remember them being as dirty as that.
I don't remember them being dirty at all, really.
We'll have a little Google search in just a minute or two. But anyway, same Biker Scout, same. Speederbike. It's a solid enough vehicle. It's a great Biker Scout. They've got this new blast effect. Oops, went back in some images. Got his tiny, teeny little... There we go. It's not the break. It's the... What was that? I don't know. Like a heater or something? A lamp or something? Maybe, I can't remember.
Maybe we'll find out in season two. Maybe we'll find out. There's all those biker scouts in the trailer.
What a weird thing to include. Anyway. Yeah, dying to know what that is now. There we go. Looking good. Pretty solid. Not a lot of paint and weathering going on here, but anyway. Yeah, tons on the speeder bike. We'll look at that in a sec. Yeah, not much else to show you. That is pretty much it with, yeah, that Baby Yoda ain't going nowhere. He's got a little, you can just see the digital printed face, the dot matrix there. So, yeah. So yes, if you want to pick them up, Target had or sold out within, I don't know, seconds, according to someone.
Of the Mandalorian? Yeah.
Oh, sorry, the Mandalorian. My apologies, not Target. Not I'm getting these too confused. Yes, the let me share properly the real screen, and I'll explain more what I mean. We're talking about Tarji. This guy sold out. Yep, the Star Wars: The Black Series Mandalorian child sold out in minutes. So
10 seconds.
10 seconds.
It was gone in 10 seconds. I had multiple people come to me saying they were there at 5 o'clock. They had it in their bag the second it went up live. And by the time they checked out within 10 seconds, I had already logged in and everything. It was, this is sold out.
So you never talked about this earlier on. And the way, as far as I know that it works is because Target is just not an online company at all. They're principally stores. Their online site can only cope with a small quantity, which is why these things just sell out. So let's say for talking's sake, they put on 500 of the damn things. That allocation went and the rest is all shipped to stores, which is why it's sold out. So there is a chance they will turn up and you'll find them in stores, but it utterly sucks as a platform and a service for Hasbro to give the product to in the first place. If it's a retail thing, during COVID in the country, which is absolutely ravaged the worst on the planet from COVID. What?
It just makes no sense. And I do know that like Marvel, for example, kind of have addressed this with Legends, with the Gambit and the Rogue figure. They're not going up online for sale.
Okay.
They're going to be, you have to go in store and get them in December or whatever it is. And it's an in-store driver for them, etc. They're not going to put it up online. And the kind of constant thing with G.I. Joe and Star Wars of giving Target these exclusive figures that sell out within 10 seconds,
yes,
which are also getting shopped in the case of G.I. Joe by the bots or whatever it was and the scalpers and all that stuff. And we knew that by the number of people who could put them up for pre-sale so quickly, multiple figures. When the Vipers and all that came out, it's not really treating collectors. I'll say it with respect. It's this whole thing of, I guess, adhering to retailers' demands or needs, which isn't really benefiting collectors in what it really is a collector's line. This is not kids and mums going out to buy these figures. These are collectors going out to buy them. And you know, you can say that this is the fifth Mando, but it's kind of an essential one if you're a toy photographer or a Mando sure. collector to get those extra little bits that people either have a shitty day like today and get pissed off with it and having to go to the secondary market to try and buy it. It's not good. And from an international point of view, that news went out today. We found out that Zing had it in Australia. What, 3 hours later, four hours later, but
sure.
other brands can go out with international information on these releases. Like Mando Monday would have been set up. It's not like Hasbro US are unaware or Hasbro's unaware with the deals they've done with people months ago. Mm-hmm. For what is the each Mando Monday? They know it's coming next Mando Monday.
Yeah.
And in Australia or the UK or whoever it is, they'll know what they're putting online next Monday.
Sure.
Everyone knows it, and it should be in the same release. You know, I don't know. It's just either international collectors are like second-class collectors where they can't get access to Hasbro Pulse exclusives. So no one out of the UK or the US and Canada can really get a Paplu Ewok or anything like that. Yeah, the other three figures will come later, but that's not the point of that Heroes of Endor box set. There's just a lot of decisions at the moment that are kind of flying in the face of collectors, and you know, Hasbro can do better on that, and they've got to do better on that. Otherwise, they're just going to keep pissing people off. And a number of people on my page are saying, yeah, I'm getting ready to throw in the towel with Hasbro. Either too many repeats or too many figures that I can't get that I want. People, like we even read in the comments, I want to give you my money and it seems like you don't want it, kind of thing. And that's what's happening. And, you know, it's not an easy thing, and 2020 is not an easy year. But this concept of pushing product into stores in a country where you can't really go outside and whatever else, you would have thought this would be the year to focus on online retailers.
Totally.
Focus on those who will ship the goods to the people, kind of thing. Now, whether that's fan channels or Amazons or whoever's got the access and the ability.
Sure.
To get these things out there, and that would have been my approach, and that would have been, you know, an opportunity anyway, but it seems like it's just missed. And again, it shows that Marvel, for example, with Rogue and Gambit, aware of what's happened with NECA stuff and G.I. Joe stuff and all that stuff, went out on their post HasCon or whatever you call that thing, PulseCon, on their kind of interview rounds with all the online channels and all that stuff. And they basically said Rogue and Gambit won't be online. They're not going up for pre-order because pre-order's not working, at least with them, or they're hearing the concerns of that. There will be plenty of them in stores. Again, doesn't serve what I just said as a treat, but it is addressing the issue that's causing lots of frustration, which is taking the frustration out of the equation. It's also saying, look, Target, like you said, Target's it's a shop. It's not an online operator. So if it's a shop and that's the exclusive, put it in their shops.
But you and I have talked to this in all these 6-inch shows we've done, how at the very beginning, it was non-existent. Global was still, it was a toilet. It was just forgotten about. Nobody cared. And ourselves and others moaned about it, complained about it, because it was just, you're right, it wasn't even second-class citizens. It was, we did not exist. Things improved, and I think those conventions where they started to release one in Italy and one in Spain and one in so forth in the UK and, you know, all around the globe, and even one was supposed to be planned for at one point for Sydney for PAX. So there was lots of stuff that was planned. It kind of fell away a little bit, but... they tried, and they're definitely trying. I mean, we're seeing stuff appear in the UK finally. I mean, those guys got shafted for long enough with just nothing turning up, and it took a reseller over there like Star Action to just list everything and take it all, because no one else was stepping up to the game to actually sell that stuff. And there's plenty of resellers across Europe and Australia and New Zealand that would take this stuff, but I don't know whether it's Hasbro Australia or, but they're just, they're kind of half-assing this again. Don't get me wrong, we're getting some stuff. But then, like today, you know, where's the other figures? Oh, we don't have them. We don't get them. Or you're sitting waiting for the other figures to be revealed, and we don't know. So the whole, it comes back, and I know I've said this so many times, but if Funko can do it, and NECA can do it, then Hasbro can do it, which is, think of global releases, pick a day, and release it, and have your stuff planned and in the system. But then it doesn't help when... everybody leaks stuff. I mean, the you and I were talking about the 3.75 retro figures, and it was contained. We knew about it, no one else was leaking it, and then, you know, some Instagrammer leaked it. You know, for whatever reason, some retailer, online retailer perhaps, leaked it to them, and it's just, so the fans are just as bad, I think, in some ways. We are, because we want to see everything. But anyway, it's getting better, but it still kind of sucks. Just while we're talking, this is what it is, if you can see that. The Target practice.
Yeah.
Remember that little piece of their shit? So that's what that's what it looks like anyway.
And they're not looking too dirty. They're looking more like the archive figures, to be honest.
They are. There's more dirt in the grooves than there is on the armor, but yeah, Hasbro's kind of weathered them a little, but hey, it's you know,
it's a good figure.
Yeah, it's a solid figure. So that is Star Wars Mando Monday.
Almost. Oh, yeah.
No, it was another, yeah, I know, but thank you for keeping me on track. Because I'm always liable to lose the plot. But some other stuff appeared. More Galaxy's Edge stuff appeared, which rumblings, rumors may be coming to other countries. But again, who knows? Because Hasbro doesn't tell anybody. So this is one that is still available, which is kind of interesting. Galaxy's Edge R5P8. Basically an R2 body with an R5 head and some bits and bobs and teeth. Basically Hondo's droid, aren't they? I can't remember who he is. Yeah, I think he is.
Don't know.
Hondo and Aka's most capable astromech and serves on Hondo's many starships. So there you go. So yeah, he is available to buy on Target.com, but again, rest of the world, you ain't getting nothing. In terms of Pyre, he's also up on Target.com, and he sold out, I believe, pretty quickly from memory. Is he back up? Hello, come on. Why is this so slow? Yes, he's available. So there you go. You can still get a Pyre. So, which is a solid figure with good elbow articulation. He looks good. So there you go. So sometimes it works at Target, but yeah, still not sure why weeks later this has not been announced in other countries. That should not have happened. It should have been announced at the same time. Anyway, I digress. So those figures are up and available. We talked about Din Djarin. We talked about the Spear Bike. Space Walls, The Return. Take it away, Matt. You know more than I do. Let me share this on screen and tell us what's going on with Space Walls.
Look, about what we're recording now, maybe in 60 minutes, 90 minutes ago, GTP Toys, who made the Space Walls, are back and their site's back up, and they've announced their 6-inch Tantive 4 set, Space Walls set, which is now officially licensed through Lucasfilm. So no longer are they doing their Space Walls and their modular walls, etc. on the side. They're now partnered with Lucasfilm, and this is the first 6-inch diorama that they've built. So not Hasbro, but it's the second time we've seen this in 6-inch scale, but this is the official one. So these are the images, and it went live about 60 minutes ago.
It looks rather tasty. It looks very nice. Thing is, that would go very well on a shelf. Well,
100%.
Yeah, just along the shelf, have your figures. I mean, that would just look great. It really would look very good. And great for toy photography.
You know, now would be the time if everyone was working together for the Rebel Trooper to make his way back into a New Hope or a Rogue One line.
Yeah, I agree.
Maybe a Rogue One line with a different head.
Well, maybe they're working in the background on that, given this is coming out and it's now official. So maybe.
So ships March, I think I just saw.
Yeah, March 2021. USA and Canada only, sadly. I can imagine it's probably expensive to ship, but that's a bit of a shame. A lot of people can't get it. Hopefully they've got some other people they can sell it to, because I think that would sell. Yeah, more on that coming up, but expect to see a lot of that in toy photography come March, April next year. What else do we have? That was pretty much it for Star Wars Marvel TAM. While we were off the last time, Black Cat and the Spider-Man Retro 6-inch line was launched. And she's looking pretty good. This looks to be an update on the figure. I don't think this was the same.
Different. So
it is different, isn't it? Thinner.
It's upset some nerds because the cleavage is covered. But it is a new body or somebody else's body, etc. But it's a new body for Black Cat, and apparently it's somebody else's head. I don't know if it's Jean Grey's head or something. Yep. Repainted and given the mask and the white hair, but it's the reuse of a head as well. But I don't really care if it looks like Black Cat. It is Black Cat.
Yeah, I think the last one, I've had several versions of it before in the past, but it was ridiculously Pawn Star-like. It was, and don't get me wrong, red-blooded male, I'm quite happy to look at that, but it was a bit ridiculous. But there you go, some nerds are, that's
all. This is accurate, I believe. This is accurate to the cartoon series, I believe. I don't think the cartoon series had the previous figures' appearance.
Yep. So she's pretty, she does look like the cartoon there a bit more. No, that's nicely done. Cat looks a bit mad, but kind of looks like it's on acid or something there a little bit. Space cat. No more cat jokes. Let's move on. Black Cat reveals. While we're away as well, the Children of Thanos came back yet again, getting re-released. So your third Thanos, fourth time Thanos has came out from Hasbro in under 2 years. So there you go. Not only that, but they've went back and retouched up quite considerably some of these figures.
They made them more movie accurate.
Thank you. Yes, exactly. And repainted them, and they're quite different, I see some of them. A quick look at the packaging on screen there. I can't remember his name, Big Dude, is now accurate because he was not. He was based off of concept art. Thanos is a bit more coloured correctly. There's the back of the
burnt arms. And...
Thank you. Yes, quite right. Children of Thanos, blah, 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 blah. I can't remember all the names. Anyway, he's much more kind of screen-like and get paint in his grooves. It looks much more accurate. And then, of course, as you said, the burnt arm, the burnt gauntlet, as well as a fresh gauntlet. But the same leg, same body, same everything. It's the same Build-A-Figure, which was then re-released several times. There he is again, looking much. He's the most different of all, with a completely different weapon. As far as I can tell, anyway. He looks radically different. I think he's got a different head as well. I can't remember. Somebody did a side by side. I should have posted it in the notes there. He's been slightly repainted, particularly in the face, I think.
And the gold trimmings kind of thing. Yep,
definitely. It's really picked up very nicely, actually. Not so much different, just little bits of paint here and there, but same figure. But her head looks to be completely different. I think it's just paint, but it makes quite a difference to her. She's not quite as evil looking as she was in the previous release. And same ridiculously. Oh, she got a sword this time. Don't think she had a sword the last time. There you go. So, Children of Thanos in a whopping pack there for $120. Recreate the snap. So, yeah, I'm expecting Amazon to reduce that at some point and everybody to flood on that thing. So stay tuned. We'll let you know if that happens.
There were two other 6-inch reveals this week, which we don't have in the notes yet.
Really?
And they are Mafex. There is the Mafex Nightfall and the Mafex Ben Reilly Spider-Man.
I think I might have grabbed them and put them on our little Trello board and not carried them forward to our notes. Let me have a look, see if I've got a link here.
So they'll be on HobbyLink Japan or something.
Yeah. There was also a Nick Fury and a Gamora.
Yes.
Let's have a little quick look at that for SH Figure Arts. And I'll share that on screen. Listen, you share that. So there we get Tamashii and their SH Figure Arts. I thought the Nick Fury looks phenomenal, actually. Very accurate.
So apparently they changed it from when they first revealed it.
Oh, really?
When they first revealed it, the trench coat was kind of cut in half where the body, the ab crunch was.
Oh,
it was kind of like two pieces, but they got rid of that and they've made the trench coat one piece.
That looks badass.
Yep.
Very cool indeed. I have to say, I think Hasbro have done some tighter facial sculpt, but that's still pretty damn good. There you go. So that's one. The other one was Gamora, which, talk amongst yourselves, everybody. Where are we? Come on, here we go. She's looking pretty good too. Come on. As big as we get. Seriously? My God, this is 1990, tiny images here. Anyway, looks pretty good. I again, I'm not sucking up to Hasbro at all. I just happen to think that was one of the finest figures they ever did. It was so good, and the blaster was so good. I do like this with the little bubbles, nice little effect there. But that was Star-Lord that had that, not her.
Yeah, yeah, there we go.
I guess.
So yeah. It's just, again, they're doing that great thing of giving some extra...
Yep.
Bonus things to a different character within the scene, but for a previous figure, which they obviously missed the first time.
I'd seen bigger images of this and it showed it a little bit better, but yeah, do check out the Hasbro one. It was pretty on the money. One of the first facial scan tech figures they did, and it was so flipping perb. I think I raved about it 1 year in their figures of the year. What was the other two figures we mentioned?
Mayfex. So it's Mayfex Nightfall and Mayfex. Oh, is it Nightfall Azrael? The blue Azrael. I can't remember. Yeah, I think it's blue Azrael.
Cool, cool. Shading. No, yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's a kind of stream. I've never seen this iteration of.
This is when Bane broke his back and he retired from Batman, and it was the Nightfall saga and. Azrael came in and became Batman for Bruce Wayne.
Okay.
He's Mr. Blondie there, yeah.
Dun, dun, dun.
So late 90s, or I don't know, but if you've got the Hush line and now they're doing Nightfall, it could mean that a Bane's coming at some stage.
That would make sense. And what was the other one?
Spider-Man Ben Reilly.
Spider-Man Ben Reilly. Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, there's been a few other images that actually I don't know whether they've actually linked to them. Yeah, that was early on. There's a few more I'd seen. That's just an image scan from Reddit, I think. Yeah, that's all that was. Anyway, yeah, they're kicking around. I wonder if we've got. Yeah, there we go. There's quite a few images of that kicking around, but pretty solid. Like it. That's quite a nice figure. Very nice indeed.
Still also, waiting for Mayfex.
What's that?
Still waiting for Mayfex to make the black symbiote Spider-Man.
You'd think they would have done that, like, toot sweet. That's kind of weird why they've not done that. Oh, well, okay. So that takes us up to Marvel. One just little very tiny quick thing. I just share this and I'm a Deadpool nut, so I loved it. But Hasbro's Deadpool does look superb. It really does. Very tomato red though, and I think that wash just made it movie Deadpool, and just so simply done. I thought it was great, the work they did there. And it really picks out all the detail in the images, the detail in the grooves of the design. So yeah, to me, it was just slightly movie Deadpool to instantly movie Deadpool. So I thought it was fantastic. So well done by ArchTom89, the Redditor who originally shared that with me. So there you go. Now the good part of the show, the sticky, jammy, oozy bit in the middle, which is much more fun than any of the other stuff, which is the page that Matt curates and brings together all of the best toy photography out there, particularly for Star Wars and Marvel and others. But let's look first at Instagram.com/StarWars, the Black Series. We haven't looked in a while. So let's see what we got, because you got some good, good stuff. So we've looked at the Mando. I did look at the comments. I might not share the comments because there's a few that are not too happy about this. But I think to summarize it up, as you said, it sold out within 10 seconds and people are pissed, pretty much. So, yeah.
Anyway. You know, just to point out, you've got people who want it or like it. That's 5,000 likes for a product photo.
Yep.
On a page where toy photography gets 2,000 and stuff. This is my point of, this is collectors talking. Yep. This isn't a... you can call it an exclusive and a variant of a figure, but it's also when it's Mando and it's about to come out and it's unmasked and all those extra features, that's an essential figure. It's not an exclusive figure.
Yep.
Should be available to everyone. But anyway.
I agree. And with the show coming into its second season, the main character from the show is he's certainly not on pegs. I've seen.
And that was the other one. The last one was still really hard to get.
It's just nuts. I have to jump to this. I've seen this before, I think, but this was the custom.
This is the same guy who made the A New Hope one, and then I shared. He'd put the Empire figures into A New Hope one again on the left, but now he's finally made his Empire Strikes Back one, and he messaged them through to me to share. Okay. And again, people have contacted me about it. I've got nothing to do with this. DM that page directly, Action Figure Display Frames. I don't know what the quote to make them are. They're all custom made. So I have no idea what the price is, but if you've got a big house and you want to display your figures in an awesome way, this is it.
Porn-tastic. That is just visual toy porn. That's awesome. Oh, I could look at that all day. So good. So, so good. Amazing job there, Action Figure Display Frames. Very nice indeed. Mando's looking good. Love this short, the armor. That's very nice indeed. Some great coloring on that. Wow. Looks so good. Shares pick 66. Would expect no less. Wow. Okay, there you go. Little IKEA lights for the looks of it. Giving off the glow using the Jabba's Palace 3.75-inch display as the background. Nicely done. That's a good touch. Gives it a little something. Superb, way to go. Good job. Again, even just that simple photograph, really, there's no pyrotechnics in it, but it's lighting that's just, wow, quite them. Really good, picking up all the purple in that, purple and black looking very cool indeed. Captimation Hyperspace Depends, buddy of mine, Matt, also Matt, I know lots of Matts. Wonderful guy, and his partner in business made hyperspace pins, and they sent you and I one of these to show off, and they're really heavy. I was really surprised how heavy this little thing was, but I love the card back and what they've done, and this is only the beginning. So if you haven't checked out Hyperspace Pins, do. There's a lot more coming from them. I've seen some of the stuff that's coming, and I guarantee you will like it. If you like some of the things that we've just shared just a few pictures that go, you'll love this. So follow Hyperspace Pins because there's some good stuff coming. But yeah, very cool. That's not the new Ahsoka, is it?
No, I think that's the I think it's the new Rebels Ahsoka. But the one next to it's the new Ahsoka with Maul in the
Oh yeah. Very cool. What's going on here? That's interesting. Trippers.
That's the meme?
Oh, so it is. Didn't realize. Of course.
It's the old troopers with the new trooper.
I like it. That is slick. I like it. Sorry, who did that? I should say. Work more or less.
Jason.
This is, you got to be kidding me. This is toys. What? This is 3.75. Shoot. Oh, nope. My God, a 6-inch. Holy balls. God damn, look at that thing. No, that's 3.75.
Nope.
It is. It's got to be.
It's not. It's not. Oh,
you're right, Jay. It's not.
It's, oh, it's my mate who's stuck out of Australia at the moment. he's in Asia at the moment, can't get back in the country, but he's the one who builds all those shelves.
Holy balls. Look at that thing. That's a movie shot. God damn it. Amazing. Hondo and Aka looking good. Looking good indeed. Yoda in the armor. Yes, somebody said. Now I can't unsee this. I think that's a hair now every time I see it. But yeah, looking good. That's the exclusive version. They're just great looking figures. They're really good. Beginning to get some early ones turning up for that. I know yours, I think, Darkseid, and others have shipped some of them, but more coming in. But yeah, they're looking good. They're looking great figures. Good job there, Darth Liquid. Seen a few of these guys around as well. Getting more and more. The Mandalorians. Reusing the old Marvel Legends blasters there. I like it. And the new look as well, looking very nice indeed. These Endor figures really are looking very good indeed. Jedi Generals there, Cad Bane, Toto, a little bit of smoke going on, Sergeant Bananas, a little bit of talcum powder or something. Looks very cool indeed. There's another one that could be a movie shot.
So these are the new troopers, and they're just a little bit of weathering and the pauldrons on there, and geez, if we're needing some New Hope figures, these are two very easy ones to do.
Yeah, they really are. Wow. Wow, yep. Hobby Lobby. Oh, boy. Don't get me started in them. Very cool. Love the display. Very, very nice indeed. Love the fan community, the fact that they've just dived in and they've already customized these today. I tried to pop the head off and try to get the head out and put other heads on, but I just, I just gave up. Just couldn't be bothered. This is an awesome photograph. Posed so beautifully, done so well. Burkhead Toys, just wow. That looks phenomenal. Really phenomenal.
And Zeb photographs so well. I remember when I first saw him, I wasn't sure how he would look, but he photographs so well.
So does this Obi-Wan Kenobi, which is still fantastic too. Don't know why Instagram's making these photographs really small.
I'm not sure what's going on.
There we go. But it was my screen size. It's just such a good Obi-Wan with a soft goods cape. Very cool indeed on the older body.
Yeah.
Much needed replacement. All the Jedi in the order. The carbonized Boba. I like this with the flames. Although I think he'd be dead without his helmet, but a very much Force Unleashed Vader from visual approach photography, looking very crispy.
And that's the old blue Phase 2 Vader repainted.
Yeah. Done a great job with that. Done a great job. As if preempting Mando Monday. There we go. The figure that I need fans had already done this to death. So there you go. Next toy picks. Good jobby. Looking good. And there we go. Finally, you can begin to build all your Ender scenes with Return of the Jedi. That's pretty awesome. Using the new Hasbro stands. There we go. I like it. Yep. They're really good stands. Hefty, sturdy buggers. Look at the amount of work that went into that. The amount of dirt that went into that.
And the placement of grass and greenery.
Damn it. Yep. A lot of work going on there just to get one photo. Plastic Action doing a good job there. Some repaints, some tweaks. I like this. What's going on here with the hand? They're using the Dagobah hand?
I can't remember, but it's also a custom head. They've taken the face off one of the other Lukes and the hair off one of the other Lukes.
Interesting.
Tad Russell, if you go to his page, you'll see all the incredible Lukes he's made from every other Luke. He's just found a better way of putting them together than Hasbro did. But it's not like he's casting or remolding or anything. He's literally just, with all the figures, just finding better ways and better combinations of already existing faces and hairstyles.
Mm. Interesting. Okay. I love this where they've got the kind of Peter Mayhew and everybody's taking a break from the set. Stan Lee's visit the set. That's epic. Wow. What an incredible smell you've discovered. Absolutely superb. Very good. And more biker skates aplenty. Wow. Back on you and just some of the other stuff you've got there, just to kind of quickly wrap up if there's anything else. Some amazing stuff. Look at that one. Oh my goodness. Dagobah Customs there. with a custom lightsaber, of course, but what a nice effect with all the blasts and the troopers and
Zay's photo, Black Series.
Oh, yeah.
Featuring the Dagobah custom.
Featuring the Dagobah custom lightsaber. Thank you. Yeah, Star Wars campaign. Everything looks good. You're right about the Zeb. Very photogenic there indeed. Very nicely done. This is Darth and the Troopers. Wow, that's a toy, man. What? Right, Status Media doing a good job. Another nice one.
Look at that repainted Obi-Wan.
Yeah, I want this scene, man. I want this in the compactor scene. Come on. Oh, yeah, yeah. So easy to do. They got the body now. Just let's go. Let's go. Let's get that scene done. Lots and lots of troopers. Sith Trooper is very good. Ooh, that's the cardboard. No?
No, this is a custom.
What? Oh, my goodness. Give me this Hasbro. The fact they did do that for the 3.75. They could get away with it, scale it up and paint it, and you know, we'd buy it, so it would be the thing to do, but just they're not quite into this stuff yet. There we go. Wow, that's very good indeed. And on we could go as the best of the toy photography for Star Wars the Black Series is curated all around the web here. And it's just fabulous. Get lost in this page, instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries. There's a lot of stuff here. Photogenic Zeb, he really is. Incinerator Troopers that look as if they've just stepped out of a movie. Tusken Raiders looking as if they're in a movie. It just goes on, and it's pretty damn awesome. Righty-ho, anything else on your toy tribe or other pages you want to highlight? Or
maybe we'll just go to Six-Inch Legends.
Let's look there.
Yeah.
Nice. Did you get your Venoms? Did you?
No, I didn't do it.
What?
Yeah.
What?
The Venom wave didn't do it for me.
What?
I don't know.
We need to.
I mean, the movie's the movie. I like my Venom Dabby's big spider on him, and you know,
okay, touche.
Like
touche.
Todd McFarlane Venom. That's okay. When they do a Todd McFarlane Venom to this style of Venom, I'll be very happy.
I like the Thanos and Cable here, very nice.
That's a whole lot of brawling.
It is. Deadpool coming soon. Can't wait for that figure. Is that Retro Spidey?
Where
here,
yeah,
wow. Cannot wait to get him. Such a good looking Spidey. Can't wait to get things like that, like without the pin joints on a Spider-Man from, oh my goodness. Marvel Legends is just going to get better and better. Strong guy looking good. Nice. Wow. That's pretty wow. Mr. Venom and Spidey. Tiny eye pick photos and it looks awesome. The mythical Red Hulk, which may or may not come because Hasbro had nothing to do with it. The Venom Pool, Venom Pool. What am I saying? Love him. Love him, love him, love him. Such a good figure. That was one of the reasons I had to get that wave. There we go. I swithered. I was on the fence to get them. I really wanted the Logan set, but I just, yeah. Did you? You never got it.
No, that's another.
No, it's another
Be in My Bonnet. It should have been out with someone in Australia and UK and all that stuff. It shouldn't have been a Hasbro Pulse, US and Canada only.
It sucked. More Deadpool, more Miles Morales. Can't wait to see the new one. I know you've seen, we saw a little bit on the preview. The Wolverine's looking great. Yeah, now I want that. Now I've got to get that. God damn it. Yeah, mind you, those two heads are not the best.
They're pretty good to the movie. Maybe not the screaming face, but the non-screaming face, I reckon's pretty good.
It looks okay there, but it looked a lot better than that other one you had. Punisher Bright with Wolverine looking good. Your new Iron Man that you adore. Lots and lots of good extra. That Storm does look fantastic.
Yeah.
She really does. Very cool indeed. I believe I can fly the Hill Club. Wow. Very nice indeed. Oh, God, I can't wait to get this figure. Oh, my God, so good. Figure Lensman looking good. Let us know what you guys are looking forward to if you're watching. What figure, what do you think of the Wolverine and Professor X situation? Is that Kraven? No.
No, it's not Puma. Cougar, is it? Cougar, yeah. Looks Puma. Like, there we go.
Puma, yeah. He was a good figure. Lots of great stuff, in fact. Agent Bob and Pirate Pool there. Very, very cool. Nice job there by Warrior Evans.
It's just using cellophane as the water too.
Was it? Oh my God, so yeah. It is. Just
does. I think there's a behind the scenes shot behind that.
That's fab. It's such a weird figure with the places to put your sword, and you can't, and then the two blasters don't work. Oh, it's like, what? Anyway, we got a Pirate Pool. I never thought we'd get one, so I really shouldn't complain. Loads of cool 6-inch here. There's a Rogue and Pyro. They look great, actually.
That's a custom Rogue, obviously.
Oh, so it is. Damn. She looks great.
But can you imagine if the Rogue was done in this fluoro kind of 90s animated version? Just,
yep.
It wouldn't be readily available like it is still now.
Yeah. Definitely. Definitely. Almost like a custom Punisher. No?
Maybe? Yeah, I think it's a different head.
I thought the body looked slightly different there. Anyway, such a cool figure. Awesome, awesome. Some of the Spider Venom Wave. And we're back to Black Cat and others. Fab job in the Daredevil here. So again, just like the Star Wars of Black Series, there's a lot of great photos. Get on, have a look. Go to instagram.com/6, the letters S-I-X, inch legends. There is a ton of stuff. Enjoying the 23, nearly probably 24,000 other people on the page. And then you'll see other stuff on Toy Tribe and others. All sorts of things like Rudy Giuliani or Giuliani, which... you watched Borat the movie then, obviously.
I watched it on Friday night, yeah.
Oh, my goodness, that's just cringed. So, yes, make sure you vote, that's for sure. Anything else we missed you want to talk about, cover? I can't think. We were going to plug, who's the dudes with the cases behind you?
It's Gonk Toys. I think it's Gonk Acrylics. We got a Gonk Toys.
Gonk Toys. That's what it looks. Yeah, I think I've... to them before. Let's have a little share. There we go. Cool. Acrylic cases, risers, packing cases. Nice.
And they're also doing them. I think there should be some photos there somewhere of yeah, there you go. Ezra, the new packaging for Black Series. Angled.
Wow. It's pretty cool, man. Pretty cool. Got a lot of stuff. Yeah, I've seen these guys before. I can't remember what I bought from them or where it was. I think it was in the States. I bought something, but it was good. Very cool. And I will mention there is a crowdfund toy kind of thing going on. I cannot remember. My apologies to the guys been sending me some stuff. And they look pretty cool. I'll dig them out for the next time we talk. I'm just trying to remember if I can find it offhand here just now. Where are we? Do we have it? Nope, I can't find it. Anyway, we'll dig it out the next time. There's a lot of cool stuff happening in toys. A lot of stuff like Gonk Toys making their own stuff, like Space Walls. There's a lot of things happening. It's pretty damn cool. I think it was Fox Forge. It is Fox. Let me just give it a quick plug. Fox Forge Toys are making these kind of cool looking figures. We were chatting away on Instagram. I kind of like what they were doing. It's this kind of trooper-like range, and it just caught my eye. I just thought, oh, I like that. Looks pretty cool. It is a Kickstarter. $25, you get a figure, and you know, for a a bunch of guys and girls making their own toys. It's pretty cool. So some concept stuff there. There's all sorts of other figures and aliens in the line too, but it's kind of refreshing to see this stuff is happening. A lot of people have the funds, the money, the time, the passion to put into it. They'll get blaster packs and all sorts of things. I mean, it's still an early...
Have you got them up on screen? Are you meant to have them up on screen?
Am I not sharing it?
No.
I'm a Muppet. I'm an absolute Muppet. Here we go. See, this is why I need you, Matt. Foxforge Toys is what I was rambling on about there. Foxforgetoys.com. There's a link in their Instagram and a link to the Kickstarter. But as I was waffling on there about, it's really cool looking stuff. Exclusive.
Almost looks like Crimson Empire kind of thing.
It does actually. You're right. Good point. So there's some really interesting stuff. If you're interested in toys and, you know, trying to find something new, they've got a lot of maybe interoperable stuff you could have with space aliens and Star Wars and Marvel Legends of some kind. You know, these kind of weapons crates and that kind of stuff. There's a whole bunch of stuff they've got going on. And they kind of trip a light. There could be some stuff with that. I don't know. They're not too shabby at all. There you go. Fox Forge Toys. Check them out. I think they're doing some grand work for their first Kickstarter. I'm pretty impressed. I would never be able to do anything like that in a million years. So good on you, dude. So there you go. 6-inch toys for you to check out. That's us for episode 70. That's it. We'll see you for 71. See ya.
See ya.